time for our camping trip. Let's meet the crew at the Metro Line. A swarm of bees is blocking the way of the campground. We'll need to divert them somehow. Grab the newspaper from the tree, the lighter out of the rocks, and a stick out of the river so you can create a makeshift torch. In the next area, you'll find a statue you can jack into. Do so, and help yourself to an HP memory. Now a bear is loose. Retrieve a pair of binoculars from behind the waterfall. Apparently, the bear is mechanical. Jack in. Grab the 1 megabyte reg up and talk to the program. You'll be attacked by a trio of spikies. Defeat these viruses to deactivate the bear and watch those heat shots. We've made it to the campground. Time to get settled. Lan will now need to collect some items for the crew. First, toss the old man on the other side of the river to get firewood. Now catch a fish in the river and borrow a knife from the girl. Give Yai the fish, Mail the knife, and Dex the firewood. Before we check out the crisis at the dam, jack into the barbecue and get a mini energy sub chip and a bubbler code R battle chip. Chaud wants us to find and defuse four detonators scattered around the campsite. First, jack into the PET on the rocks. These detonators are organized into grids, but hidden bombs make the areas into mazes. I'll fill you in on the different viruses you'll find and at what point you'll find items. These handies are new. They'll place time bombs on your side of the field. If they hit zero, you'll take a lot of damage, so destroy them quickly. Between points 2-1 and 1-1 is 500 Zenny and a dead end. You'll also be seeing these spikies again. Don't get burned. Between points 1-1 and 0-1, you'll find a Cannon Code C battleship. Get to point 0-0 to defuse the first bomb. Our next target is the canteen in the campground. Grab 600 Zenny in between points 4-1 and 5-1. You'll now start seeing bombs in play during battles. If it gets hit with a fire attack, everyone on that side of the field will get nuked by the blast. You can grab a wide sword code L in between points 1-0 and 1-1. Again, get to point 0-0 to defuse the bomb. Now check behind the waterfall for the next target. The link between point 4-2 and 4-3 holds a panel grab code L battleship. Between point 4-0 and 5-0 is 1500 Zen. Not too far away between point 1-1 and 2-1 is a 2 megabyte regup. After defusing this bomb, Chaud will tell you to look for a suspicious character who may have the final detonator on hand. Near the camp entrance, talk to this guy. Looks like he's got something to hide. We have one more bomb to defuse in order to save the campground. You'll now start encountering the Met Fires, which attack with meteors. They'll often hide behind rocks, so use battleships with wide ranges, like Spreader. between point 3-1 and 3-2 is Recover 50 Code N Battle Chip. Grab another power-up between points 3-5 and 4-5, and another bug frag between points 2-2 and 2-3. Two last items to collect. In between points 0-3 and 0-4 is an attack plus 10 code star battleship, and in between points 0-1 and 1-1 is 3000 Zenny. To defuse the last bomb, you'll need to be Quick Man. While he's standing still, he'll block all of your attacks. He can only be hurt while zapping around his field or attacking with his boomerang. Navi chips will really help here, and hopefully your attack has been significantly powered up. When Quick Man dips under half hit points, he may try a double attack. Keep your eyes open and be ready to react quickly. Mega Man has a big test coming up in the next episode. Stay tuned.